Welcome to 5 at 5 with Stone Law Offices. I'm attorney Brendan Bybee with 5 minutes on the difference between living wills and DNRs. Now, living wills are part of one document among many that may be considered advanced directives. Okay. Now, when you come to our office and we put your estate plan together, we'll prepare as part of your advanced directives, your healthcare power of attorney and your living will. Now, these cross over a little bit in terms of what they cover. But again, going back to the living will, both of them cover concepts regarding your decisions regarding the end of your life and the care that you want to receive and when you want to be permitted to die naturally when you're in a state where there's no known medical treatment that can restore your life and your functioning to the way it was before, and you're otherwise essentially in a long terminal condition, vegetative state, and where quality of life is minimal to none. Now, that's why we use living wills, is as that advanced directive regarding that care to say, okay, the doctors can now withdraw life-prolonging treatments, life-sustaining treatments that are not restoring any health, but merely keeping our tissue in a living state. Now, how does that contrast with a DNR? So, DNRs and pulsed, POLST, pulsts, these are documents that are also considered, maybe considered advanced directives. They are also directive to your healthcare providers in terms of what kind of care you want, when they are to withdraw or discontinue any kind of intervention that they're providing for you. Now, a DNR stands for do not resuscitate. And a lot of times people can get confused with the living will and the DNR. They think that they're the same thing. And it's understandable because they both do cover some of those end-of-life care decisions and the withdrawal of healthcare interventions that are merely life-prolonging. Now, a DNR is not something that we can give you. It's not something that you can come into our office and we can prepare for you. And that's one of the big differences between that DNR and the living will. The living will is not going to be something that you can give to an ambulance driver and say, look, they don't want to be resuscitated. It doesn't go to that level of detail. It doesn't provide that particular instruction. That is really for healthcare providers after they've done everything possible, which cannot be done in an ambulance. They've done everything possible to try to restore your health and vitality and no longer able to do so, and decide that you are essentially there's no improvement to be made, that decision can be made. The DNR is specifically for situations where you may go not just unconscious, where you may die, you may lose the functioning of your heart and brain, and where they may otherwise resuscitate you. And it is specifically for those situations where now if a ambulance comes because you have fallen and your heart has stopped beating, that they can follow that instruction and not resuscitate you. And that is only going to be possible for you to obtain through your physician. A physician can only provide those to you when you are in a terminal state and you are near the end of your life, so that you don't have to go through the difficulty of being resuscitated where perhaps you're losing ribs as they're trying to restore your heartbeat, and where other things they might do put you in a situation where you have a long-term recovery under a great deal of pain. You're already expecting death to come in a short period of time. And so that's why those orders are given, is to avoid that type of circumstance. And a pulsed that is very similar to a DNR, but is actually more detailed. The DNR is simply, if you find this person and they have lost functioning and they are otherwise basically deceased, they've lost their heartbeat, do not resuscitate them, do not bring them back. What the pulsed does, it's physician's order for life-sustaining treatment. So what a pulsed does is gives more detail. So it can include the same instruction as a DNR does in terms of if this person loses their heartbeat, do not engage in any intervention to bring them back. But it can also include other instructions regarding that life-sustaining treatment, what is and is not going to be done. And that's something that, again, you'll sit down with your doctor, go through in more detail about what it is that you want, what your values are, and what they should not do during that stage of your life. You can avoid whatever life prolonging that you're trying to avoid, or the effects of any intervention, such as might occur under resuscitation, where the benefit to you personally is not worth the pain of recovery from those interventions, such as when they are doing chest compressions and things like that, that can result in a great deal of physical trauma. So again, difference between a living will and a DNR and a pulsed. The living will is something that we can provide you, and it's an opportunity for you to say when you want that plug to be pulled. The DNR and the pulsed are provided by your healthcare providers, by your physician. When you are in a state where death is within arm's reach, you could say, and where you have the opportunity to go through and determine what those things are with the advice and order of your physician. If you have any questions about these, if you have not yet put these documents together in terms of that living will and healthcare power of attorney, please give us a call so that we can sit down, go through those options with you, and help you get your intentions stated now.